How many chromosomes can you find inside a human karyotype? And how can you write correctly the chromosome formula? Hi, I am Saha from the Bio Academy, and if you want to get a higher mark in biology easily, so you are in the right place, subscribe to this channel and let's start our video. So, human karyotype and chromosomal formula. What we're gonna talk about today, we will label a chromosome and see the different parts of this tiny chromosome. We will analyze a human karyotype and we will learn how to write exactly the chromosomal formula in the case of a normal karyotype. So what you are observing here in this photo, this is the microphotography of a human karyotype. And if you try to count these chromosomes, you will find out that there are 46 chromosomes. If I take one of these chromosomes and I schematize it, and then now I'm gonna label the different parts of a chromosome. Each part of this chromosome is called chromatid, chromatid with a D at the end and not an N. So chromatid, and this red part that connects the two chromatids is called centromere. Okay? The two chromatids of the same chromosome and connected by a centromere are called sister chromatids. So the sister chromatids are the two chromatids of a single chromosome. Okay? Now, human karyotype. So if I take the microphotography of a human, I cut the chromosomes out and I arrange them. I arrange the chromosome according to the criteria we learned before, I will obtain this karyotype. Now let's count the chromosomes. 2, 4, 6. If you keep counting, you will obtain 46 chromosomes. And these chromosomes are arranged in pairs. Each one pair, the two chromosomes of the same pair are called homologous chromosomes. From where do they come? One of these chromosomes is coming from the dad of this person and is called paternal origin. However, the other chromosome of the same pair is coming from the mom and is called of maternal origin. So in each pair, in the homologous chromosomes, one chromosome is of maternal origin and the other chromosome is of paternal origin. Fine? Now, we said that we have 46 chromosomes in humans, and this 46 is constant in humans unless this human has a certain abnormality. So, we say that the number of chromosomes in human is 2n equal 46. And why 2n? Because in each pair, we have one from the dad and one from the mom. One paternal and one maternal origin. So, overall, I inherited 23 chromosomes from my dad and 23 chromosomes from my mom. So, we name each 23 N, one number. So N maternal and N paternal and plus N, this give me 2N equal 46 chromosomes. Okay, so if they ask you about the number of chromosomes in a normal human, your answer should be 2N equal 46 chromosomes. Now, in these 46 chromosomes, the first 22 pairs, pay attention, the first 22 pairs, all these chromosomes with a number below, these are the autosomes. And we said that they are common between males and females. Okay, so either we say the 22 pairs of chromosomes, or we say 44 autosomes. Fine? So I have from the 46, the first 44 are called autosomes. However, the last two, they are called gonosomes. And these gonosomes, or sex chromosomes, are XX in the female and XY in the male. Okay? Now, let's have a look on this female karyotype. So, the first 44 autosomes, or the first 22 pairs of chromosomes, are called autosomes. And look here, I don't have any chromosome above Y. So, there is no Y chromosomes. However, above X, I have two gonosomes X. So, I have two X, and therefore, this karyotype is belonging to a female. So, whenever they ask you to indicate whether the karyotype belongs to a male or a female, you look to the gonosomes. If you find two X gonosomes, so this is a female. If you find X and Y gonosomes, so this is a male. Now, I'm gonna teach you how you can write correctly the chromosomal formula. To write the chromosomal formula, you have to write how to follow these three steps. The first step, you write the total number of chromosomes. And what do I mean by the total number of chromosomes? So all the chromosomes, including autosomes and gonosomes. And then you write down a comma. And finally, this is a comma without an, so a comma, and finally, you're gonna write down the gonosomes. How? Let's see. So, in the first step, you're gonna count these chromosomes, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and you will find out at the end that you have 46 chromosomes. So, you write down 46, and then you put a comma, and finally, you look at the gonosomes. What do you have as gonosomes here? XX, so you write down XX. This is what we call chromosomal formula. Another example. Now, let's write the chromosomal formula of this karyotype. So, first of all, the total number of chromosomes, which is here also 46. Then you write down a comma. And finally, what are the gonosomes? XY, so we write down XY. So 46, comma, XY. Now, finally, let's sum up what we took today. So in a body cell, what do I mean by body cell? A body cell is all the cells of your body except the sex cells. We're going to talk about this later. So in a body cell, you will find 46 chromosomes where 44 of these chromosomes are called autosomes and only 2 gonosomes. And these gonosomes are XX in a female and XY in a male. Certainly, I'm talking about a normal male and a normal female. And how do you write the chromosomal formula? You count the total number of chromosomes, you write it down, then you put a comma, and finally, you write the gonosomes you have in the karyotype. Okay?